channel and do another true crime video, which I know I haven't done one in a while, but this case is very similar to another case that I've covered on my channel, and it deals with a young woman and a military cover-up. I do want to say, if you are an active true crime listener, sign the petition. It would be wonderful to get a lot more signatures added to the petition to have people look back into the case. And so I will link it down in the description box. My heart goes out to LaVena Johnson and her family. This case, as all of the cases that I cover, are heartbreaking. This one's especially heartbreaking. And I will be referring to my notes to make sure that I correct. I have seen a couple other YouTubers cover this case, and I don't want to like talk poorly on anybody else, but they have talked about things where I'm like, where did you guys get that information? Like, so I'm going to stick with what I read and what I learned. But I hope you guys enjoy this video, and as always, if you don't like this type of content, you don't have to watch. That's the great thing about YouTube. You can just exit out the little corner.
Some other videos, and I heard other people report about it. I
writing this information down, but I want to mention it, that it was, you know, alleged that she had been sexually assaulted a couple weeks prior to her death, and she wasn't really keen on making like a big deal about it. It was reported that she didn't want to seem like helpless, didn't want to cause a lot of attention to what had happened to her. You know, she was there to serve, etc., which I wanted to mention this detail. I wish I had more information to give you. I couldn't find the information about it. I don't know where the YouTubers that I, whose videos I watched, found their information, but I wanted to mention it in case anybody says or mentions it in the comments. So, she also had just spoken to her parents. She was always talking to them. You know, not always, but like once a week she was checking in on them. She expressed her absolute excitement that she would be able to be home for Christmas. She even told her parents, like, hey, don't decorate the tree before I get back, because that's something that they did as a family, and she was really looking forward to being home for the holidays. So on the day she died, the military claimed that she was upset because her boyfriend of 2 months had broken up with her. She had printed out the emails, stuffed them in her pocket, and took her M16 service weapon over her shoulder and went to buy M&Ms and a six-pack of soda at a military store with an unnamed male friend. The investigators also said that two soldiers returned to the barracks, but then LaVena decided to leave on her own, so she came back with her male friend. She was like, I'll be right back, or whatever. So this time, she's alone. She made her way to a tent belonging to a military contractor, and once she was inside the tent, it's reported that she found a can of aerosol, lit the breakup emails on fire, and then set the entire tent on fire. According to investigators, LaVena, just being absolutely distraught about the breakup, took her 40-inch M16 rifle into her mouth and fired a bullet. But I want to take this opportunity to mention that LaVena was like 5'1". She was a very petite, small woman. And an M16, I mean, 40 inches, like, that's huge. Nothing added up. Dr. Johnson and his wife were immediately suspicious. His wife was like, Linda was like, not my baby, she wouldn't do this. She was just talking about coming home, looking forward to the future. Like, it didn't make sense as to why she would kill herself. And the more that Dr. Johnson, who was a military vet himself, as I mentioned before, the more he was told about his daughter's death and the circumstances around it, the more questions he had. And he kind of came to his own conclusion that his daughter's suicide wasn't a suicide at all. Like, there was definitely something else at play here. So the body was sent overseas for the family to have, you know, they sent bodies overseas. And the military's autopsy showed that LaVena had sustained a busted lip, broken teeth, scratch marks on her neck, but no serious injuries, which I feel like those are like kind of serious, but they said it wasn't serious. And if it was a suicide, like, how do you break your own teeth? How do you bust your own lip? You know, if you shoot yourself, it just, again, things aren't adding up. So when Dr. Johnson saw his daughter's body, he was like horrified. Her face was still bruised. He later found that plastic surgery had been performed on her face to conceal a broken nose, indicating that she had been, you know, more assaulted, like had been basically beaten up, right? Like, she's bruised, she has a busted lip, broken teeth, like a broken nose, like she was assaulted. He also noticed that the bullet wound in his daughter's head looked far too small to actually belong to the weapon that the military said it was, to the M16. And that it was also on the left side. LaVena was right-handed. It didn't make sense where the entrance was of the bullet. To ballistic experts, Donald Marion and Cyril Wecht state that LaVena's alleged M16 exit wound is more consistent with a bullet wound from a 9mm pistol, so not one from an M16, which is what she had on her. The bullet about like body parts being missing, etc., etc. So I also want to mention that the M16 that was found at the scene was at a different serial number than the one that she had. So it wasn't her M16. And she was never issued another M16 rifle as well. And nowhere in the military's criminal investigation record does it disclose who was issued the M16 that was located at the murder scene, nor does the military explain what happened to her own M16. Something also to note was that there was no suicide note. She left no note to her family that she loved and spoke to. And there was nothing suggesting that she was in a suicidal state. Her family spoke to her. She seemed happy. Everything seemed good. She was looking forward to coming home for Christmas. So, I want to talk about some theories now. Private LaVena Johnson had met a commander sometime earlier, and as fate would have it, LaVena wrote his name in her personal notepad, and she actually mentioned to her father that she had met him as well, because I guess he was like a high-ranking commander. What LaVena did not know at the time was that this commander was engaging in an extramarital affair, which is not allowed if you're serving in the military, I believe. Like, I don't know what the exact rules are with that, but he was asked by higher-ups, like, hey, you gotta end this affair, like, now. And he continued his behavior. It is suggested, like, this theory is that LaVena walked in on the commander engaging in this, you know, explicit but also forbidden affair, and the commander assaulted her, knocking out some of her teeth, breaking her nose, fracturing her neck, and inflicting other injuries on her body, and then dragging her body. I'm going to read also. This series of events is supported by the military's own records and explains how and why a battered soldier with a fractured neck was shot in the top of her head, why there were no discernible fingerprints on the M16 found at the scene, and why there was no gunpowder residue on LaVena's hands, why no M16 bullet was found even though an empty M16 shell casing was later planted next to her body, and why her tongue was removed during the military's autopsy without any reference to its removal, why the military stonewalled the release of its investigation report to the family, and why the commander was unexpectedly fired from the command position. So again, just because of legal things, I have to say alleged. This report that I read, that the alleged commander that was the one who actually killed LaVena is former four-star Army General Kevin P. Bynes, and LaVena had written his name down in her notepad a few days before she died. This is the commander that she had met. Burns was warned, you know, by the higher-ups, hey, end this affair, and he just outright disobeyed orders. I also want to share a little bit of literature from the Huffington Post about Kevin P. Burns. In modern times, no four-star general has ever been relieved of duty for disciplinary reasons. Prior to this incident, Burns had a spotless military record. He has been separated from his wife since May 2004. The allegations do not involve anyone under his command or connected to the DOD, and he was already set to retire in November. Something doesn't add up. Would the Army really can a four-star general with 36 years of service, 3 months shy of his retirement because he screwed someone other than his wife in the middle of a war? No, indicating that he was caught and killed LaVena probably out of fear of losing his retirement package, and that the military protected their own and she was caught in the crossfire. I want to add that today, General Kevin P. Burns lives a comfortable life in Huntsville, Alabama, where he works as a top executive for Raytheon. And I mean, this is again alleged that he was the one, but again, it kind of adds up. Like, that's a very plausible theory. The other theory as well is that, I mean, that she did commit suicide, although highly unlikely considering guys stay safe out there, and I will see you in my next one.